Hello, today we're going to talk about species interactions. By the end of today's notes, you should be able to answer the question, how do members of different species interact with each other? When looking across all ecosystems for similarities, ecologists have found that species interactions are similar across all ecosystems. These interactions include predation, competition, and symbiotic interactions. Let's start with predation, which is one species benefits by eating another species. In this case, species A gets a benefit and species B suffers the consequence. An example of predation is the interaction between a cheetah and a gazelle, where the cheetah gains energy by eating the gazelle and the gazelle loses by... it kind of gets eaten, and that's pretty bad. Now let's move on to competition. In competition, species limit each other's access to resources, such as food, water, shelter, and so on. Since neither species can get as much as they could, it's a lose-lose situation for species A and B. An example of competition can be seen with the gannets and the dolphins. If the gannets get more sardines, then there will be fewer for the dolphins. But if the dolphins get more sardines, then there will be fewer for the gannets. The result of competition is that each species gets less. Symbiotic interactions require species to live in symbiosis. The word symbiosis can be broken down to together and way of living, or simply put, living together, which means species A lives with, or on, or inside species B for a long period of time. Three types of symbiotic interactions include mutualism, commensalism, and parasitism. Mutualism is probably the most well known. In mutualism, species A and B help each other. That's a win-win for both species, as they both get a benefit. An example of mutualism is the interaction between the plover and the crocodile. The plover will go into the crocodile's mouth and clean its teeth. The plover benefits by getting a free meal, and the crocodile benefits by maintaining its healthy smile. Commensalism is probably one of the least known, but just as prevalent and important. In commensalism, one species benefits, but the other species is not hurt or helped. So that's a plus for species A, and a zero for species B. Commensalism is the interaction between owls and trees. The owl benefits because it gets a home, but the tree doesn't benefit nor is it harmed by the owl living in the tree. Finally, there's parasitism. This is where one species gains by using and harming another species. So species A gets a win, and species B loses out because it gets hurt. An example of parasitism can be found with humans and lice. These parasites drink our blood, causing irritation. Lice benefit getting food and a home from this interaction, while we get an itchy scalp in return. Now you should be able to answer the question, how do members of different species interact with each other? That's it for now. Till next time, bye!